Thank you, House Chairperson. My name is Nazli Sharif, and I am a feminist. Born in 1990 to a South African mother and a Mozambican father, a product of the new South Africa, I am a young woman raised in a single-parent household in Johannesburg, and the legacy of my ancestors that were enslaved, shackled, raped, and brought to South Africa and Mozambique respectively, often against their will. Generational trauma, Mr. President, runs deep through my veins, as it does with many women spanning centuries. The history of women across the globe and our current lived experience is riddled with pain and violence. At some level, at every age, women are subjugated and equality remains a far-fetched ideal we can't seem to grasp. Like many women for centuries, my first memory of assault that I can remember as a young girl was by a family member. I couldn't have been older than 7 years old when he touched me inappropriately. I remember when I was 12 years old, I menstruated for the first time. And with puberty, my body started taking shape and changing. I will never forget going to ShopRite with my mom and standing in the aisle. A man groped my bum and my thighs, and I felt dirty and disgusted at myself for a very long time. Imagine, Mr. President, a 12-year-old girl thinking it's her fault. I felt his hand on my body for months after the incident, even though I bathed and I scrubbed the area he had contaminated. This happens to many young girls every single day, Minister Mashabane, when they are violently touched without a thought of respect, dignity, and consent. The system cannot fail them as it failed so many of us. As I got older, I was in my final year at Wits University. And I remember going to the shop and getting catcalled from inside my car and followed to the shops, harassed. I was so terrified that I went to the cashier and answered their questions simply out of fear. Deputy President, this happens to almost every single young woman walking to the shops to go buy bread or walking to school. This is not only my story. This is our lived experience. The fear of being raped is a fear many young girls and women live with. The trauma of being raped is carried by too many women, and the pain will be felt by many generations to come. But just like many other women, Mr. President, it doesn't stop there. The objectification of our bodies continues with us throughout our lives. It doesn't matter who you are. Simply being born a girl child means that your experience in this world is a violent one. I remember getting elected to Parliament, and immediately I was objectified by my fellow male MPs, grabbing my wrist, touching my hair, or moving past me and grabbing my waist because they need support. Even here in these corridors, as a young MP who happens to be a woman, I am not equal. Before we preach about equality, let us start by holding ourselves accountable. We cannot pretend to care on this podium and then perpetuate patriarchy outside. You cannot write speeches about the effects of GBVF when you do not unlearn toxic masculinity. My name is Nazli Sharif, and I am a feminist.
Thank you.